Hello everyone, today continue our bow and arrow tutorial part 2. Now let's go to project settings, edit, project settings, go to input and set action mapping. Right mouse, click on the keyboard sign, then click your right mouse. Add one more input, name it left mouse. Left click, or you can select it from this search menu. Close it. Then go to our third person director blueprint. Search for event right mouse. Input action. Click print string right event. Left mouse print string left. Compile it. Let's play. When we click the left mouse, we will print the word left, and when we click the right mouse, it will print the word right. Correct. Then create blueprint interface, name it BPI animation blueprint. We create this to call the function from our third person character. Add name menu function, call it set bow on hand. When we equip the bow on the character hand, input we need the variable is bow on hand. One more function, set aim, input is aim. Compile and save it. Find our animation blueprint menu. Open this, then go to class setting. Add our animation blueprint interface that we just created. Open this. Compile. Then we can see this function. Just click on it. We have two functions. One is set aim, one is set bow on hand. Let's print string. Go to anim graph. Drag our blank space bow on hand. Then create blend pose by bold. When it is true, we have to create our variable promote to variable aim. Bow on hand and connect our main state to false. If the bow on hand is true, we will play this blank space. If it is false, we will play the default animation. Then create one more blend pose by bold. Get aim, and if it is false, we will apply this main state. drag our blank space, aim. We need the side speed and the forward speed. We can create new float, name it speed forward, set it to float, then create one more is speed side, set speed forward and set speed side. In even update, try get pawn owner, get our director velocity and set actor forward vector, get actor forward vector dot product of these two values and get actor right vector dot product of velocity and the right vector. Add it with dot product of the velocity and up vector. Get the absolute value. Then plus left the float between speed forward and this dot product value. For alpha, it set it to 0.1. Left speed side. Alpha is 0.1. Now we get the speed forward and speed side of the character by getting the velocity dot product it with the forward vector and right vector. After that, go to ending graph and apply that speed forward and speed side to our plane space. Speed side. Go to third person character blueprint, create two right ball. First is bow on hand and second is aim. And when we receive the right mouse input, we have to check that the bow is on the character hand or not. If it's false, set bow on hand to true. Then we have to call anim instance set bow on hand. Then we play animation montage, equip the bow animation, create the animation montage, right mouse, then create anim montage, apply it on the montage to play. If the bow on the director hand is true, we will aim the bow. So create custom event, name it aim bow, call the event. And when we release our right mouse, we have to create a timeline, name it time to release, open it, set the length to 4 seconds, add float track and play from start. When it finish, we will release, create custom event, release bow, call our release bow event. When it finish our event, when we release the bow, set bow on hand to 4, then get match, get ending instant, set bow on hand and play animal type. We have to play the this arm animation. Create animation montage. Right click, create any montage. Apply any montage on montage to play. So now let's play test this logic. Right mouse. After 4 seconds, the director will disarm the ball. Yes, it is working. Now we move to aim ball animation. We check if the aim is true or false. It means that the director is aiming or not yet aiming. You have to make sure the ball is on the director hand. If the aim is true, we set the aim to false. Set aim to the animation blueprint. Opposite to that, if the aim is false, we set aim right ball to true. Same function. Then we play the animation montage. Play montage. Before we aim the ball, we need to draw the arrow first. Create draw arrow animation montage, then apply it to montage to play. When we receive the right mouse input, if the ball on hand is true, set aim to false because we not yet aim the ball. Create another right ball, call it aimable. When we release the ball, set aimable to false. Check if we are aiming or not. If we are aiming, we have to call the event aimable. Set aimable to true when the ball on hand is false. After complete playing the equip animation montage, check if aimable is true, call aimable event. Then when we release the ball, make sure that aim is false. Aimable right ball, set it to true for the default and play test. Right mouse, release. After 4 seconds, it disarm the ball. Again. Yes, when we hold the right mouse, it's aim. And when we release, it put the ball on the character hand and disarm. You can see the foot of the character is sliding when she walks. We have to correct that. Go to your third person character blueprint. After we equip the ball, get character movement, set walk speed to 125. When we disarm the ball, set the walk speed to 230 back. For aim ball event, when we not aim the ball, get director movement and set orient rotation to movement to true. When we draw the arrow, set orient rotation to movement to false. And when we release or disarm the ball, set it back to true. When the character is aiming, it will not turn to the walk direction. And when we release, the character will turn to the walking direction. When we aim the ball, use controller desired rotation. Set it to true. When we aim, the character rotates with us, but the rotation is too fast. To slow down the rotation, go to your input, multiply it with 0.2, and when it is not aimed, multiply it with 1. Now the camera rotation is slowed down. Go to input action jump, and we don't want the character to jump when the animation montage is playing. Create a branch. We jump when it is full. If the bow on the director hand is full, we do the simple jump. And if it is true, we play dive forward animation montage. Create dive forward and name montage. While our characters dive forward, we have to stop the timeline to release the bow. Create custom event. Stop. Release. And call it stop release. After the character dive forward, animation complete. Check if aim is true or false. If it's false, we release right mouse input. Create a custom event. Call it release right. And if aim is true and bow on hand is true, set aim to true. Call set aim function from animation instance and set orient rotation to movement to false. Set character movement speed, walk speed. Set character walk speed to 125. Press space on the keyboard to jump. Yes. It's correct. And if the character is jumping, we have to stop the character from equipping the bow. It's playing anime loop motion. If it is failed, this is the result that we get. In the next video, we will make the character a ball to pull the string of the bow, and we will create the control rig for our character leg. If you have any question, please comment in the comment section below, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. It really means a lot to me. And thank you. See you in the next video.